नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज आफ्टर एक्सरसाइज 15 ए नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ ट्रायंगल्स. सो फर्स्ट वन इज एक्यूट एंगल ट्रायंगल. इन एक्यूट एंगल ट्रायंगल सिंपली ईच एंगल इज लेस देन 90 डिग्री. इन एक्यूट एंगल ट्रायंगल ईच एंगल इज लेस देन 90 डिग्री. So that triangle will be acute angled triangle. Then next is right angle triangle. In right angle triangle, one angle is exactly 90 degree. So in this diagram, angle XYZ equals to 90 degree. This middle value indicates angle. And as you can see, we are having angle at Y, which equals to 90 degree. And in chapter 16 Pythagoras theorem, as we have studied that in right angle triangle we are having three sides perpendicular, then base, then hypotenuse. The bigger one side is hypotenuse. And how to identify that in a given right angle triangle which side is said to be hypotenuse? Simply, angle Y is your 90 degree, side opposite to this angle is XZ. So in this triangle XYZ, XZ will be your hypotenuse. Then remaining two sides XY and YZ, simply you can take XY as perpendicular and YZ as base. So what is a right angle triangle? In a right angle triangle, one angle will be exactly 90 degree. Clear? Then third one is obtuse angled triangle. So in obtuse angled triangle, one angle is greater than 90 degree and the other two angles are just less than 90 degree. So for example, this is your A, B, C. Angle B is 110 degree. So this is your type of obtuse angle triangle. Clear? So now we have divided triangles into two parts, in two bases. The first one is with regarding to their angles, which I have explained now. Second one is regarding to their sides, which I will explain now. So in terms of angle, we are having acute angle triangle, we are having right angle triangle, then we are having obtuse angle triangle. Clear? But what about sides? Have you ever imagined that if three sides of triangle are different, then if two sides are equal, if all sides are equal, how we can classify? Simply, if you are having a triangle and in that triangle, suppose A, B, C. It is given to you that AB is 6 cm, BC is 6 cm, AC equals to 6 cm. As you can see, in this triangle ABC, we are having three sides AB, BC, AC, and all these sides are equal, having value 6 cm. So when three sides of a triangle are equal, then that triangle is equilateral triangle. Clear? Then what if you are having other triangles? So the first one is what? In equilateral triangle, all sides are equal. Then if sides are equal, that means all angles are also equal. If this angle is 60 degree, this will be 60 degree and this is also 60 degree. 60 plus 60 plus 60, how much you will get? 180. Clear? So next is isosceles triangle. Now what is isosceles? P, Q, R. Now it is given to you that PQ equals to PR. So this PQ and PR, these two are equal. So when you are having two sides equal in a triangle, so that means that particular triangle is isosceles triangle. Now this PQ and this PR, these two sides are equal. Clear? This PQ and this PR, these two sides are equal. That means angle opposite to this PQ will be angle R, and angle opposite to PR will be angle Q. These two angles will be equal. Because if two sides are equal, that means their opposite angles are also equal. Clear? Then next one is scalene triangle. What about scalene triangle? Simply, when you are having all the sides different, suppose this is 4 cm, this one is 5 cm and this one is 6 cm. A, B, C. As you can see, all the sides are different. They are having values like 4, 5 and 6. So this is your scalene triangle. All sides are unequal. Clear? Then next we are having isosceles. So next one is isosceles right angled triangle. In isosceles right angled triangle, we are having a combination of isosceles triangle and right angled triangle. Isosceles means what? Two sides are equal. So let in this particular triangle P, Q, R, side PQ and QR, these two sides are equal. Then the meaning of isosceles is clear now. But what about this right angle? Simply, right angle means what? One angle is exactly 90 degree. So as you can see, this angle Q, this is exactly 90 degree. Now sides PQ and QR, these two sides are equal. Now if we want to find that what will be the value of angle P and angle R, how we can find? The basic is very easy. Simply, this side PQ and side QR, these two sides are equal. So if you are considering this side PQ and side QR, as I explained you now, that when sides of a triangle are equal, that means opposite angles to that sides are also equal. Kisi triangle mein agar do sides equal hain, to unke opposite angles bhi equal hote hain. Jaise yahan pe hum baat karte hain side PQ ki, to side PQ agar consider karte hain, to PQ ke just opposite fir kya remaining hai? R remaining hai. Theek hai? Kyunki triangle hamare paas kaun sa hai? Sirf PQR triangle hai. इस पी क्यू आर ट्रैंगल में हम जब पी क्यू साइड को कंसिडर कर रहे हैं तो बचा क्या? फिर बचा आर. इसका मतलब एंगल आर जो है, अब यहाँ पे क्यू आर, तो क्यू आर के अपोजिट एंगल कौन सा है? पी एंगल है. तो एंगल आर और एंगल पी इक्वल होगा. तो दो साइड जब ट्रैंगल की इक्वल होंगी तो उनके अपोजिट एंगल्स भी इक्वल होंगे. आप अगर पी क्यू साइड लेते हैं तो पी क्यू के अपोजिट आपको एंगल आर मिलेगा. अगर आप क्यू आर साइड लेते हैं तो क्यू आर के अपोजिट आपको एंगल पी मिलेगा. तो एंगल आर और एंगल पी इस रिलेशन से इक्वल होंगे. एज्यूम कर लेते हैं कि ये एक्स डिग्री है, तो ये भी एक्स डिग्री होगा. क्यों? क्योंकि दोनों एंगल इक्वल है. अब ट्रायंगल पी क्यू आर में एंगल सम प्रॉपर्टी यूज़ करते हैं. तो एंगल सम प्रॉपर्टी यूज़ करने से एंगल पी प्लस एंगल क्यू प्लस एंगल आर, तीनों का सम जो होगा वो कितना होगा? 180. एंगल पी एक्स डिग्री है, एंगल क्यू 90 डिग्री है, एंगल आर भी एक्स डिग्री है. इक्वल्स टू 180. 90 को ट्रांसपोज करते हैं तो x प्लस एक्स 2x, 180 माइनस 90, तो सिंपली 2x इक्वल्स टू 90. फर्दर वी कैन सॉल्व 90 बाय डिवाइडिंग 2, सो वी विल गेट x इक्वल्स टू 45. सो दिस एंगल इज 45 एंड ऑल्सो दिस एंगल इज 45. सो इन दिस वे वी कैन सॉल्व ऑल द बेसिक्स आई हैव एक्सप्लेन टू यू नाउ एंड नाउ आई विल स्टार्ट एक्सरसाइज.